Howdy, y'all. It's me, Farmer Dr. A.J. Robano, and I'm back with a bonus track, a reward for all you hardworking financial farmers. Now, in the last episode, I answered the question of why I started with the harvest before talking about the planting time. And hopefully you remember that it's because it's important to know your desired outcome so you can properly prepare for success. Now today I want to tell you the second reason, and this time from a slightly different standpoint. Now, did you ever hear the expression, what came first, the chicken or the egg? Well, I like to change it up and ask a better question. What came first, the harvest or the seed? I mean, originally that is. Did you ever think the seed for your first harvest had to come from somewhere? Maybe someone like a banker loaned it to you and you put in some sweat equity perhaps in the company that you used to work for. Or maybe you're one of them lucky people who had a parent or a mentor gift it to you. The point is, the seed had to come from somewhere. It didn't suddenly appear out of thin air now, did it? Now I want you to keep this in mind. The seed for your next harvest is wrapped up inside this harvest. Now look inside the core of this apple. What do you see? I don't know what you see, but I see seeds. Now understand, inside that seed is not a specific number of apples, but there is the potential for multiple apple trees with inside those seeds, provided you follow the courses that we taught you before about properly using your time. Now, y'all remember that from a couple of episodes back. And one good apple tree, though, can produce hundreds, perhaps thousands of apples during each harvesting season for years to come. Now, let me ask you another question. What would happen if you ate all the apples and all the seeds? Well, you know for sure you'd cut your next harvest off completely. You'd have barren land. So remember, to get a bigger harvest, you need to invest a greater percentage of the seeds from this harvest than you keep for yourself. Now in the real world, that means you need to sow back into advertising. Maybe try a little geofencing with that Cheryl Palmer lady. Or perhaps you can talk to, T Russell, and learn a little bit more about the media group and how they can get your name out there. Don't forget about that old man Marcus Pino Grigio. Nah, I mean Marcus Merlot and the social media guru. And of course, the Ukrainian sensation himself, Vasyl Skilidilyarov, and the web media master. Invest back into yourself in a savings type of route. The most important thing though is that you remember the process. Now, secondly, I want you to think in terms of apple trees and not individual apples. It's something referred to in the business world as lifetime value. Now, lifetime value is especially important in industries where an individual sale may only be a few dollars, say in a dry cleaner shop, where a customer may only spend maybe $5 or $10 every time they come in. But now, it's important to remember, they may come in more than once, and if you're giving good service, they'll come in 40, 50 times a year for 20, 30 years. Now, how would that affect how you train your staff? What would it tend to produce if your staff thought they were only a $10 customer and didn't consider the lifetime value? But if they consider the lifetime value, you can guarantee that your profits will rise as you have more and more happy and satisfied customers. Think about how you handle transactions where maybe they're not so happy, but you can fix it and produce lasting lifetime value. Remember, train your employees and train your fellow BNI members to think about the lifetime value of your clientele. So you see, understanding how this harvest affects your next planting and future harvest is critical to your ongoing success. Now listen, I look forward to seeing you this Friday at our BNI Synergy meeting downtown, and I look forward to talking to you more next week as we continue our series and take a deep dive into the planting time. Y'all come back now. You hear?